Started sparring less than 12 when I was 22. So I was pretty well established at that stage. And you know, like, I think I sparred about the Glen Gale of Offingham. I think I probably sparred about 8 or 10 guys the first night. And I got out the ring and I said, what's this with lad, mate? I said, Lester Ellis. I said, this kid's going to be a world champion. We're going to train together. And it was up until, you know, probably a year before Lester, he really hit the big time, that we were still sparring regularly. And every time we sparred, he tried to kill me. You know, of all the guys I've fought around the world, not many had the power, the speed, and everything that Lester had. And every spar was like a fight.
Train his son Darcy to get in the ring as well. Is that surreal for you?
And you know, if you had said to me 10 years ago, I'd be in the Team Ellis gym, you know, helping with Lester's son, I would have said you're probably crazy. About a week before he had his first professional fight, and I was just going to leave, and he just said, Baz, can you jump in with me and show me how to throw the left body?
Bend that knee.
You've got a kidney, left kidney and one kidney, and it's the liver. And once you hit there, it's very painful, hurtful, but it's just like a stitch from hell. And I had 25 knockouts as a professional and 18 of them with the left rib. I mean, it doesn't matter how fit they are, how tough they are, when you hit there, you've got to be accustomed to it, or else they do hurt, they do.
I think he can go a long way, but you know, you don't want to put too much pressure on him. There's a lot of media interest already because it's Lester's son. But you know, we're just going to take it step by step, and I think and see it all unfold. And you know, it's going to be exciting.
So Paul's determined and smart.
Darcy's different kettle of fish to Lester. He's far more reserved, he's a very good thinker, calmer, and I think that's a good thing.
When did you know that you wanted to be a professional boxer?
Well, as a kid, I always dreamed about being a professional, like being big fights and stuff, but not until about probably 18, 19, where I really started kind of looking at what I kind of, what direction of life I want to go down. And at about 19, I decided this.
One day he came to my bedroom at 3 o'clock in the morning, he was dead. He said, piss off, I talked in the morning, he's like, mate, I don't want to do boxing. You have to really like it, Dad. You have to really like it.
When my dad started, that's why I started, so much more, you know, so for me, I just see that.